Greetings, viewers. Me and team here. Welcome back to Let's Play EU4 with the Mongols. Yeah, we're looking good now. We're starting to look like the old Khan. It's putting pressure on people. Pushing into China, crushing Russia. Speaking of which, though, we're still a ways away from being able to do a whole lot. I am accruing some claims to put on Nogai. It's something to do in the interim. And with Timurids beating on him, perhaps now would not be a bad time after this claim is pressed to go for them. And of course, no, they're not. They're going for this one. They have a claim on that? Nope. Timurids be greedy. Oh, I could have like put claims on this too. There's still time. And of course, I'm being trolled by my vassals. Causing me manpower loss, but yeah, we're pushing back up near full manpower, so not too big a deal. And we have our claims. What kind of numbers do you have, Nogai? Probably not so high any longer. Okay, they have absolutely nothing at all. Perfect. My kind of war. The kind of war where you just need a lot of strategic planning to even have a chance. Oh no, now they have a unit. I should be careful. Be careful. Definitely want tribal conquest, or tribal feud. And we'll just go for this one. Tribal feud halves your aggressive expansion, and makes a lot of your stuff no diplo cost. And we value no diplo cost at the moment a little bit, so it's just something to bear in mind. Grodd's taking care of some stuff for us, so we'll just run there. And do I have another general unassigned? I know I have a decent general somewhere. Let's find him this way. Oh, well, no, he's not actually a decent general. That's right, I had a good general that was my ruler that died, that led to that succession crisis. But this is going to be my anti-rebel stack for the time being here. And I just stand on that because your religious government. Oh, a decent heir. That's useful. I've mostly had good rulers this game, to be honest. And that's how it works for hordes. You mostly get good rulers. Well, okay then, just go there. And since you're here anyway, sure. We got newer possible advisors. In addition to the stuff we got from admin ideas. Ah, joys. We're gonna get lots more Russian provinces soon. Converting all this stuff. For fun and profit. Okay, so that's all Buddhist. Not surprisingly, the Buddhist stuff would have been easier to convert. Because it's both not hostile culture and has no conversion resistance, unlike others. Come here. We'll have fun together. We'll fabricate a claim on you. At this point, I don't mind using tribal CV on them, though. Bang Long is not possible for me to convert. But I'm chewing through all the other stuff, for sure. And I don't even have a theology, or not a theology, and I don't have an Inquisitor. If I had an Inquisitor, I could convert Bang Long, I'm pretty sure. Good news. Oh, come on, man. I guess I'll take him out, so it's not a big deal. Ignore them. We don't want to pay monarch points. Monarch points are sacred by comparison. Siege of Rin is over. I should actually look at like which provinces are reasonably valuable. I mean, that's high tax, but it's not a good. Good. Although, 1 point... Well, it's better than the metal right now, for some reason. Wool's not very good. Nogai, you're not very good. Just putting that out there. Oh, whatever. They have decent provinces. Mongols are such a terror, I love it. We're at 100,000 troops available. Just gotta get ready for these derps, the auto derps. Ideally, they come to odds with France, and oh my gosh, Styria's out? Let's have a look at Europe, yeah. I mean, aside from my complaining about this nonsense, Europe is certainly interesting. Hesse has grown, England has not really fully realized its potential, to say the least. And it kind of has junk for allies. I guess the France-Spain alliance all game long is kind of broken, so that's something. Denmark has mostly held together the Kalmar Union, not entirely. Gone Protestant, sure, sure. Probably not too many good allies there, and I'm starting to fear them less and less. Of course, these guys are going to sit on the Ottomans all game long, unless I can PU them, or... ooh. If only. There's two problems with that. First of all, I'm not their religious group, so I can't PU them, and even if I could, I couldn't integrate them. But second of all, they're allied to the Ottomans, so an offensive PU would mean fighting the Ottomans anyway. And by the time I can do that, I'm not going to care if I can get a PU over Crimea or not, since that's only going to be one or two wars. But it's always fun to see someone have the same dynasty you can pick on. Yeah, as promised, this becomes a very valuable province, even without it being accepted culture. Just same culture group, and it's worth over 90 income a year. That's just gross. Really need to pause for that. So I definitely want this belt, since I took the time to claim them. What else do I have a claim on? Doesn't really matter. Oh, we're 91% done with our vassal there. Quite handy. See, it's not totally worthless to vassalannex Ming, it's just much less valuable than previously. There's a difference, if only a small one. Still, I have two of the three regions I need, for the most part, for the achievement, which is the Russian region. Well, I don't have all the Russian region, but I'm close. You need the Russian region, Persian region, and Chinese region. I pretty well have the Chinese region already, since vassals count. And Russia is pretty well shattered here. There's not much doubt that I'm going to be able to handle this. But the final one is going to be a little tougher. Yep, just go there. Yep, easy natives. I could hop into the colonial game in the east. Just go straight east and get into a brawl over the colonial nations. Make Mongol Mexico. Aztec are probably gone by now, though. But Mongol Mexico is great. We probably don't need these guys any longer. Do I have any mercs left? No, we don't need mercs. It's time to start relying on regulars once again. And I can recruit from better stuff too, so... in fact... this is reasonable. Leather cannon! Oh, I need to get attack before I can recruit new troops that are of any quality. Oh, I need to end this war, too, while I'm at it. So there, there, there. Not that one. I only got three claims in? I could have sworn I got another one. But now I don't remember where. Or no, maybe, maybe someone took it? Maybe I'm just misremembering. I'll just take whatever. Definitely my three claims are... worth my time, but none of this is costing Deplo, so... except for Sarai. Why is that costing Deplo? Oh, because it doesn't border me. The tribal stuff only gives you border provinces. Nope. Okay. This works for me. Can I core all this? Probably, because I have tons of boosts on it. Yikes! I took over 100% overextension. I really need admin efficiency. This is gonna hurt. Even though I'll court pretty fast, it's gonna hurt. And yeah, I can afford it. That's amusing. Instant revolt. Oh, I am now bordering QQ. Oh, jeez. And on top of that, I deleted my mercs. I could just rebuy them, but I think I'll just use my regulars. I should have enough numbers. Put them together and fight down the rebels. Oop. Finally got one of them. Took a while. Of course, they don't have a lot down here, and it's, like, junk troops now. Actually, a chambered demi is not a junk troop. But the other stuff is, so we'll just get rid of the junk troops. Because certainly I am very welcoming to cannons in my army. My army is sadly lacking in cannons and the ability to afford cannons. Ugh. Except for mercenary cannons are gouging. They really hurt. You don't want to use them. They're too expensive. That said, we are happy to have more of China, believe me. Do I have a truce with them still? Yeah, but it's almost over. I love it. I actually have less revolt risk in the Heretic province, but that's probably because of other stuff. Oh, it's because of the Cantonese versus Han, that's why. Those get ignored. It's not even that valuable of a province. We're gonna go beat down these guys if I can get there in time. Kazan pretender rebels. Ooh. Well now, that changes the equation a little, I think. Now those guys are low morale and can be handled. Yep, we're getting those events again. Hurry up and finish coring, please. At least some. No! My admin points! Why? Curse you! Okay. Go ahead and convert that. And these guys are shock 5? Yeah, the rebels get like super. That should be enough of the overextension, super overextension anyway. Yeah, we're almost done, in fact. Other than the nationalism. But I can just accept rebel demands if I have them converted, so, you know. Assault! I think I'll convert this earlier stuff first. Yeah, see, Nizhny Novgorod is only a 5-base tax, but it's hostile culture, so that's why I'm having such a hard time converting it. Yep, can never have enough manpower. Really can't afford to spend military points too much. You need to funnel all those into tech, because it's only going to get harder. Actually, that's not true. It eventually gets easier to stay up in tech, as a matter of fact. Now, can Zoe handle Ming? Yeah, probably. Oh yeah, I'm still annexing Novgorod. At least that won't be nationalist. Can never have too much manpower. Always good. Lots of manpower. Crush Crimea. Stop making me try to ally Kashmir. That is lame. Although I'm getting a ton of those. I don't mind. Manpower is a good thing to have. And so is recovering it. And yeah, let's just get the claim spam on the road again. No guy has nearly been eliminated. Alright, well, I will be right back once something interesting is happening beyond annexing vassals, coring, and dealing with rebels. You get the gist. Alright, we are back and we are spamming claims. A couple quick things here. Muscovy, where are they now? Man, they've been beaten down a little bit. Yeah, they're not so strong, and they're still only allied to Pomerania, so I've been spamming claim fabrications on Muscovy. A lot of their provinces have it already. Once I've fabricated on everything I can, I'm going to go in on them and probably Timurids. And with the 75% cost reduction, it's crazy. I've just been intermittently declaring on Meng and pretty much letting Zhou do all the work for me. Not a whole lot to say about that. They're almost done, and then I'll annex them and have more than my fair share of China. I noticed Ayutthaya had disputed succession and had a pretty old ruler, so I royal married them and claimed their throne. Nothing will probably come of it, but hey, you know, sometimes you get cheap freebies. Tibet will have to go eventually, but there's no true rush there. Although, I have military access with Karakoyunalu, and I could probably vassal annex Tibet without too much trouble using Zhou. So I'll just do that right now, as soon as I cancel military access with QQ. As far as conversions go, we got tons of Buddhists, but I don't really have to worry about that. Let's convert Sarai. And yes, we have a rebel hunting stack set to automate on that, so I don't have to worry about that too much any longer. Another one? Man, we're almost done with Crusades, though. Get rid of that asinine crap. Okay, so we get some prestige from the events. No longer have a conquest claim on Kashmir. Let's cancel this. Oh man, they would take an alliance. Would they take vassalization? No, because they're not the same religious group. I pretty much am done with legit people that can be offered vassalization that are worth my time. Champa, Hinduism's no longer same religious group. It's considered its own. They're probably a little too big still, although you never know, that might work out eventually. Majapahit's gonna be too far away, and they're Hindu again. Yeah, so there's no, like, serious Buddhist presence any longer. Orissa's looking kind of cute there. I just realized Orissa's got that whole, oh my gosh. Yeah, I guess it's dogpile and Muscovy day. But I'm still fabricating claims on them. No, Muscovy. Screw you. I worked hard to completely eradicate you. And it's not done yet, but it's closer than it has been for most of the game. Yeah, they got broke really hard in that last war. Yeah, we're getting there on the colonies now, too. Sending more and more. In fact, we've pretty well covered all the stuff, except for these couple provinces. I even am colonizing Taiwan. Should have done that sooner. And since I've conquered ores, I'll probably just pick these guys up and drop them here and colonize as much of this as they'll let me too, because that's usually pretty high quality stuff, so. Okay. Tibet has no allies, no help. Easy vassal job. I'll just let Zhou take care of that. Actually, what are their relative techs? Zhou's behind them. That might not actually work out. Well, we'll see. Doesn't really matter much. Ooh. I am taking attrition here. Well, I can always split my stack. Yeah, Muscovy's a little angry over my previous conduct. I can't imagine why they wouldn't be too happy with me. Nope. Ah, shoot. Neither of these are appealing. But we are going to finish this first. because that gives us every one of our national ideas. And goods produced nationally, 10%. That's pretty solid. And we even get a stab cost reduction idea. Resilient state. Yes. So, do I get policies? I can add policies now. Of course, these cost one per month, so colonial restrictions, very not so useful to me. I don't have any CNs, and I don't really need religious unity that much. Settler chance, it's not worthless, but it's not worth admin per month. Colonial range and trade power, I really don't need colonial range. Once you have diplomatic 7 and full exploration, it's kind of silly. School establishment, stab cost, and production efficiency isn't bad, but we are hurting for that less. So yeah, well, what's our ruler's age? He's 33, the heir is 10. I can actually make the ruler a general. You know, how much are my stab costs these days? Oh well, it would be less though. It's not bad, but I'll just make my ruler a general. And rely on the next guy. I will delay the cost. Ooh, he's a 3-shocker. You could do worse than that. In fact, you are on rebel hunting duty. And you just get random podunk. Crap head. Hopefully Zoe wins eventually. I guess it's not critical if they don't. Fight it out over there. It's not my job. Okay, so, you know, I don't have claims on everything of Muscovy's, but I have an awful lot. And this looks, oh no, they're moving. They're gonna get away into Kazimov. Are they fighting the Ottomans? No. I need you to ally somebody else, Crimea. They want my provinces. Who has rivaled me by now? Japan and France, and I have rivaled Crimea and the Ottomans as my only options. I'm surprised that Crimea is considered an eligible rival. Well, let's just keep fabricating claims. Almost done fabricating claims. Pretty useful to have them. As they reduce the coring cost. Just going back and forth. We're gonna play the idiot game. Watch that war end automatically. Because no one fought anyone. I'll be annoyed, actually. Yeah, oh, and by the way, I'm making $9.90 a month, but we're running plus 3 advisors across the board, and we have the, we're still getting the power projection stuff, too, so being lost provinces in our war, conquered provinces from no guy, so yeah, we're holding up there. A lot of conquered provinces from Muscovy. Eventually we'll have to actually, like, beat down some people. Oh yeah, and I'm training some dudes there. And apparently QQ no longer wants access with us either. Ooh, oh no, that's just Diplotech. I don't really care about Diplotech. In fact, I'm gonna need it to, annex Zoe eventually. That is, if they do their job. Because Ming's only like one or two wars left. Probably two, because they'll leave the capital in the last one. No! Save scum for PU! No? Okay. Man, I just keep getting caught fabricating these things. Not that most of these guys care. Well, they don't care about the claim fabrication. They don't particularly like the Mongol hordes on their borders regardless, but it's not because I'm fabricating claims, apparently. They just want my stuff. Okay, we got another claim on Muscovy. Vladimir and Yaroslav. Where are those? It's these two. I think I can stagger my claim fabrication. They will call upon their coalition members. Now we can use tribal conquest. Because these guys are screwed. Declare war. They are winning the war against Crimea, though. Although they are looking to be in a pitiful state. I'm gonna go, I'm gonna block them off from Crimea and just siege these guys out. In fact, you go there, getting ready for them. Yeah, I really miss, like, when with Byzantine, when I had conversion strength, and it wasn't like this, where you just don't get it. The Eastern religions are not as lull or bad as they were before, but they're still pretty rough. Not what I would call good. Man, double tapping me, huh? Well, that's why we have a official rebel hunter. Whoa, easy. Yeah, they're going in on Vladimir. I can probably cancel that, though. Yeah, they're not really interested in that. What? I don't think they'll win that, will they? It's hard to believe that they could beat a Shock 5 on my own territory. But just in case, I'll be ready to bring in at least a little bit of reinforcement. Oh god. No, I have a feeling they're not gonna win this. In fact, I'm gonna cancel that and just go back to sieging. You can come along. What's this? Must westernize to compete with Nomad? Is that what I heard? Ooh, someone just died. Oh, it was my trash tier dude, though. I'm not too bad shape about that. Oh, they're going all the way up here, I bet. Muscovy pretender rebels. Leave me alone. Do not help. They're going to help. They're going to help frickin' Muscovy. I hate when the computer's rebels just decide randomly to help them. Those pretender rebels have been around forever, too. That's the worst part. Can I kill them before the month roll over? No. No, I cannot. Yeah, I'm not so good off my own turf, though, because I don't have, iron or conquistador. Ooh, it's a good one, too. A lot of people don't know you can do this for some reason. I'm gonna show it off here. Yeah. As long as you select the unit off the transport like that, you can actually land in TI. I'm not so sure I'll win that. Nor do I need to go crazy. I can probably discourage that. And nope, we don't need to let them get away. Catch him out. Always trying to catch him out. Of course, I'm getting my terrain screen here, but that's okay. We only have shock four. We're course I'm not even fighting with all my troops, and I'm like at a quarter of my force limits. Alright, so now we just send colonists, and I don't need you there anymore. Go ahead and dock. Cambodian nationalists? What? Who are you gonna defect to? It's interesting. There shouldn't be any valid, oh, whatever. Oh, wait a minute. That will not work. That will cause me to lose. We shall not do it. Man, they're recovering quickly. Frickin' Muscovy. Yeah, well, defensive ideas, you do get the fast reinforcements. Now what do I do about it, is the question. Oh no, they're sieging me. Oddly. Which I don't mind. That's gonna do a lot less damage to me than me sieging them will do to them by a percentage basis. If you cancel it like that, they'll take the closer thing. If they're automated. Get rid of those. Might be able to make it over there. The rebels are causing grief though. Unsurprisingly. Ooh, can I afford this? Yeah. I'll have my legitimacy. Build it. Build the palace. Do these guys have any cannons? No, they're just wobbly sieging this. But I'm recovering in troops, so I'll be able to handle the Muscovy again. Makes a big difference fighting them in my territory versus theirs. Because as the game goes on, fire is better than shock. It's the first combat round to go, and it gets all the multipliers for both infantry and artillery. And the artillery fire is a pretty big deal as the game goes on. So yeah, that can be a big deal, actually. Let's see if I can get a bait on them. Interesting, they're just going to Yaroslav right away. And remove no leader, no leader at all. And now antagonize them. Nope, not gonna happen. They want my siege stack dead. Can't say I blame them for it, but it's not very convenient. Actually, I shouldn't let them kill it because I have a superiority CV on them. They're going to Kazimov? Yeah, okay. It's completely obstructed by the Crimea dude, but that does seem to be their intention. No, I don't mind. That's how you want to roll it. And we will just leave your capital and quite a bit of the rest of you sieged out. And in fact, we get two fort level ones here, so you know, just toss a few dudes. Wanna grab my claims after all. Yeah, actually, I wanna get a bait. We're gonna do a bait. Ooh! Hold on. September 26th, September 18th. No, that's no good. That's better. With home field shock advantage and all my infantry recovered, I can probably inflict a fair amount of damage here. But I should probably recruit more troops, because I am going to need them eventually. Although not yet, because they're almost tech 19, and they get a new unit then that will allow me better troops. Aw, come on. There's a crossing penalty too. And the forest. They even really increased like the draw in the forests. Nice. Horde home field to the rescue. Oh, they're going over here. Yep, just keep sieging them out. Have a claim on this? Yeah, I do. Yeah, I'll just make some drunk troops to handle that. I do have some positive war score against Tibet. They'll give up eventually, maybe. Shoot. Oh, wait a minute. Let's go for an intercept. They're gonna be like that. Ah, we are getting into the tough stuff now. Novgorod will be a real chore. I'm not surprised that Novgorod, the nation, could not handle converting that to Buddhist. Novgorodian nationalists. Let's, oh, I can't support that. Are they mine? Yeah, they are. Where are you going? Oh, you're going up here. I don't think that's gonna work. February 8th. Whoa! I might have missed the boat there. No, they're caught. They're definitely caught. Good, 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 good. That's the kind of outcome we look for. Boom. This time the forest really was crossing. No, their cannons are taking it. Once your cannons start taking it, you are in bad shape. Oh no, they're retreating this way. That's bad for them. I'll take it though. It's about as nice of an outcome as I could ask for. It's gonna be carpet siege time very soon. In fact, I'm just gonna prep for it. Really? Really? Like the day I go in, just about? Oh, that's so lame. Why? This happened in the one of the earlier ones, too. And we're gonna deny. Actually, no, we're just gonna put a proper siege force here. Even if it requires just dropping cavalry. And go ahead and cover that. And then if I can shatter these guys. There we go. Yes, I have a leader, but I also have four times the forces here, so that should be alright. Plus they're getting insufficient supply. So that usually works out pretty well. Now, will they shatter into one of my siege stacks, or will they... No, they're just gonna shatter right into my territory. Works for me. Gone. What? Where'd you come from? They might be able to wipe me up there. Oh, they could actually recruit mercenaries up there. And in fact, I'll just grab another two merc infantry to get rid of that. Are you tech 19 yet? Yeah, they're tech 19. That's a pretty useful jump, because now I'll be able to build some better stuff. Oh no, I will not. What? Why can I not? Let's have a look. Well, judging by this, they probably just haven't switched it because they're in the middle of a war and didn't want to get their morale boost busted to pieces, so we'll see if they switch after the war. Alright, we are back in the game. And these guys are kind of being a pain. In fact, I don't need all my forces there, so go put that down. And then you can just relax. Permian Nationalist. Please tell me this is in a, well, I guess it doesn't really matter, because I still have my Rebel Hunting stack, which is, at the moment, busy, Yeah, Rebel Hunting stacks aren't the most brilliant things. I'm just gonna assault this too, and speed them up a bit. No, Muscovy, I want your everything. So you're not gonna be able to recover from this. Plus, I want these guys, because they're part of the Russian region. There it is. Get rid of that. Yeah, well, I probably should have told my mercs to come back, yes. Although I don't have a claim on Yaroslav, so it's not a big deal. Man, the 100% on Muscovy is always gorgeous. Reform society, and nah, just give him more autonomy. Oh, I love these events. Yeah, yoink. So cheesy. Just perfect. I love the horde events. I actually, you can get an AI's capital that way, or anyone's capital that way. Yeah, this is just not the same war as the old wars against Muscovy. That's for certain. I probably want to dump these mercs once I'm done with them in this war, though. Yeah, let's just dump them, because they are mostly junk. That is the one unfortunate thing about staying horde with horde ideas, is that you just can't take the full abuse with your mercs like you could before. Are we done here yet? Not yet, but pretty close. Maybe now. Yeah, sure. Congratulations on your vassal. That took me so much effort. In fact, while we're on that note, how are you doing, Zoe? Not too bad. I think well enough to handle, No, I don't want to declare war on Zoe. I want to declare on Ming! Because Ming will not be able to survive Zoe. And we are almost done with Muscovy. Just stay at war with them forever and gradually steal all the land with war. It's too slow, though. Although it's funny. Heresy! I'm not gonna flip my province. I've only had one province flip event, so they are correct that they did reduce it massively. That particular patch note is not a lie. That actually did happen. Because if this were, like, patch 1.5, I would have had so many provinces flip already. Although the sad thing is, it really doesn't matter. I've made no effort to convert the Buddhist provinces, because it doesn't make a difference. And that's the way I like it. Oh wait, that's actually confusion. Although wait, why am I getting tax income efficiency penalties now? I wasn't before. Yeah, now I'm taking a penalty here. Why? Why am I taking a penalty? Huh. So I do want to convert Buddhist provinces, just not as a priority. That's the conclusion to take away. I was mistaken earlier. Ooh, Lithuanian noble rebels. That's not very useful to me at all. These are the ones I don't have claims on, aren't they? That's probably why I under-prioritized them when I wasn't thinking a moment ago. Do I have any overextension? Oh yeah, the stuff I, stuff that the game gave me is a freebie. Yes. That looks like about all I can do to them for the moment. And it's going to be a very, well, it'll be a hit to aggressive expansion, although the people who care are mostly Russian miners in their religious group. So yeah, we'll just take peace. Now this is what's awesome about these late game setups. Look at these core costs. 27 for 5 tacks. Although, I will probably vassal Muscovy until I get something better so that I can continue to build good troops, because something like this little guy is just not gonna cut it, although he's not far behind. Riazan has entered into a military coalition. Ooh, Denmark entered it. Butt hurt, what? They did it with 12 AE, huh? That's, it's amusing. And of course, now we get the revolts. You go cancel. I guess you guys just hang out in Nizhny Novgorod or something. Or no, you're decidedly not what I want. I don't want mercs. Not little itty bitty. Weakling mercs. But only enemy troops now. Unless I just need mercs for sieging or something. Yeah, we're gonna take some hits here. That's alright though, we have troops for it. And this won't be too hard to deal with. Draft it! Where's Novgorod? There we go. Pretty good supply limit there. Not a bad resting place for units. And now it is time to fabricate claims on Muscovy and Timurids. Nice. Game's not messing around with me now. I have a lot of nationalism from this. But that's okay, we will do what the original Great Khan could not do. Even though I keep getting caught fabricating claims. Man. Can't be that hard. Just finish off all but one province of them, please. Then we'll gib them in the following war. More agricultural revolution. There we go. New stuff. How many infantry do I have right now? There were only 2 pips better, so I probably don't want to just delete all my old infantry. But, yeah, we can afford a decent amount, so what do you think? Like 50 of these guys? Or, wait a minute, is this, no, I haven't converted this yet. I want to do it out of one that might not rebel give me. Who's a reasonably high tax province with low, well, you're in act of being converted now. You're not a Russian core. Or a Muscovian core, whatever. It looks like, well, yeah, I mean, the thing to do is to convert the lower stuff first. And I'm not really cost-optimizing this. Still, I want to take one that's not terribly high in nationalism any longer. This isn't bad. We'll just dump a few, like, here, and maybe... Man, that one's brutal. Siberian... Yeah. It's built, like, 50 of the New Age infantry. It's not quite as good as building cavalry, but it is cheaper. And that's something, actually. Because best army composition does depend to some extent on your funds. It's not just what the theoretical optimal army comp is, you also have to manage what you can pay. Okay, yeah, they got it. Well, fair enough. It's worth checking. These guys are, Man. I see what people mean when they say their manpower gets annihilated by the rebels. I mean, push comes to shove, just accept their demands. But I would rather not deal with the religious unity problems, and I have manpower to burn, so... That's fine. Almost done. Draft citizens. Oh, I can afford that. Yeah, we're already done corn some of these, and how much longer in the truce? Yeah, it's like taking 2 years in hostile culture with a 75% core cost reduction. In fact, and what's left? What's left? Oh, we're almost done with it all. This is all Buddhist. It's a kind of cute gimmick, but Buddhism just, or going tolerance just isn't the way to go, I don't think. Or maybe it is, just because you can't really... You just can't convert that much at once. So maybe it isn't, from that perspective, the way to go. Yeah, there we go. I'm getting there now. Just the stuff with rebels left. Such a great sound. So now, let me see if I understand this region map mode a little bit better. That's different from before, and now it makes sense. Unfortunately, these are autos, so yeah. I need to conquer this region as well. And it looks like I have pretty well taken care of business for the Chinese region. Just need to take a few more provinces off Ming. Korean region, Japanese region, Manchurian. Yeah. And Russia, well, we have Crimea to deal with. Let's hope they ally somebody other than the Ottomans that wouldn't take world lead if I declared on them, because Crimea would take world lead from Persia, without a doubt. Without a doubt. Alright, viewers, I'm going to finish up the war with Ming and set up for some brutal battles with the Timurids, most likely. In fact, I just have one more claim to fabricate on them, I believe. Same thing with Russia. And, I guess I can show this. I'll see you in the next part. Me and team, signing off.